Hello friends, here in this video we are going to see Euler's theory for long columns with its assumptions. Let us get started. Now Euler's theory. In 1757, a Swiss mathematician Leonhard Euler gave the formula for stability of long columns. In 1757, as I have written here, a Swiss mathematician Leonhard Euler, he gave the formula for stability of long columns. Now when Euler's theory was designed, Leonhard Euler, he considered only the bending of column because he was analyzing long columns, and in case of long columns the bending is more compared to the direct compression. So Euler considered only bending of columns as the direct compression was negligible compared to bending. So Euler, while designing the formula, while deriving the formula, he considered only bending, because when the column is long, in that case the bending of the column is more as compared to the direct compression. So here I am drawing a diagram of a long column subjected to load. So when under the action of this load, the column will compress as well as it will bend. But here, since the length of the column is more, the bending is very high as compared with the direct compression, because load is acting in the downward direction, column is fixed at the bottom, so there will be direct compression, but that direct compression is less compared to the bending value. So Euler considered only the bending of columns, and therefore I can say that Euler neglected the direct compression of columns. So he neglected the direct compression, and hence Euler's theory is applicable only for long columns. So this was regarding the Euler's theory. Now I'll write down the assumptions Euler made while deriving the formula for long columns. So the assumptions which Euler made were, first assumption is the column is subjected to axial loading. It means the load which is acting on the column will pass only through its axis. Load will not be eccentric, that is away from the axis. It will pass only along the axis. This is an assumption. But in actual cases, if we see, columns may also be subjected to eccentric loading, that is away from the axis. So this is the first assumption. Next, material of the column is homogeneous and isotropic. Now the meaning of homogeneous and isotropic is that the material which Euler assumed, homogeneous means having same composition throughout, that is if a column is made up of steel then it will remain of steel throughout. It means the theory is not applicable to composite columns, that is having two different materials. Next, isotropic means the material of the column will have same modulus of elasticity in all directions, that is x, y and z direction. So this is also an assumption. Next, the material of column is elastic and obeys Hooke's law. So Euler assumed that the material of the column being elastic, it means when the load is applied the column will deflect, as I have shown here, but when the load is removed the column will come back to its original position. So that is also a part of assumption. And for Hooke's law, here I'll show the graph for Hooke's law. Hooke's law is basically a graph of stress on y-axis to strain on x-axis. So it is a graph of stress versus strain. Hooke's law means it is a graph of stress versus strain. And within this Hooke's law, it states that within the elastic limit, stress is directly proportional to strain. That is, here I'll say that up to point A, this is the elastic limit. So within this elastic limit, stress and strain, they are directly proportional. That is, at this point zero, where the stress is zero, strain is also zero. But when stress will increase, strain is going to increase. Again, if we increase the stress value, strain increases. If we again increase the stress, strain increases, and that relation is linear up to the elastic limit. So Euler assumed that the column is following Hooke's law. Next, the length of the column is very large compared to the other dimensions. So it means that Euler assumed that the length of the column is large compared to the other dimensions, which are called as lateral dimensions. So he was analyzing just long columns. Then self weight of the column was neglected, that is the own weight of the column is neglected, and we are considering only the external loading on the column. But in actual case, even because of the self weight, there is some amount of compression in the column. Then the column is straight before loading. It means that the column is not initially bent as shown here. Initially it is not bent. Initially the column is straight, and when the load is acting, then only the column will bend. So again, this is an assumption made by Euler. So by taking these assumptions, he derived the formula which was later called as Euler's formula, or called as the calculation of Euler's crippling load or Euler's buckling load. He gave the formula, but before deriving that formula, he assumed these points which I have written here. So in this video, we have seen assumptions made in Euler's theory.